Don't worry about my conscience, sweetheart.
Now for the really good stuff. Check out the Roxie Cinemas Festival Women of the 30s, including Barbara Stanwyck, Kay Francis, Anne Harding, and best of all, the beautiful and highly strung Norma Shearer. This is an amazing festival at San Francisco's Roxie Cinema. It goes on for 11 days, over a dozen women stars, a lot of very rare and socially important films. 23 of them were made before censorship hit in 1934 and basically just wiped out this kind of women's picture. This is definitely worth a look. For Channel 7 News, I'm Mick LaSalle.
Steven. Tonight in San Francisco, the Roxie Theater is presenting an ambitious retrospective of some of the most famous women's films of the 30s. It was an era when some say that Hollywood dealt honestly and openly without censorship with women's role in society. Mick LaSalle, what was so special about this era?
What was special about it is that you have a period, you have a flowering of just about 5 years between 1929 and 1934 where Hollywood was allowed to make films that dealt honestly with women's issues, but you also had a period of history, one of those rare periods of history, where people wanted to see movies about women. I mean, this is not the case now. All the big stars now are men. Probably the last really big female movie star was Jessica Lange, who, you know, somebody who could actually pack a theater. We're talking about 10 years ago. Whereas in, let's say, 1931, the top six box office stars were women. And women were very interesting at this period of history. I mean, if you go back, we look at a film, let's say, like When Ladies Meet, or The Divorcee, or any of the Norma Shearer movies, and we say, wow, you know, it's kind of like our time. Well, go back 15 years. What you're seeing really is the birth of the modern era. It's
well,
very interesting.
Let's take a look at our first film clip. It is When Women Meet, starring Anne Harding and Myrna Loy.
You don't think for one minute that Jimmy cares anything at all about me that away, do you?
Oh, I hope he does. Nothing could be finer for Jimmy.
Well, nothing could be finer for me, for any woman. Jimmy has the makings of a great husband.
What?
Oh, yes, something that's very rare in men. He really doesn't expect women to like him. And having once found the one he wanted, if he got her, he wouldn't be looking around. Because it just wouldn't occur to Jimmy at all that anybody else would want him. Oh, that makes a marvelous husband.
Yes, but who wants a husband nobody else wants?
Oh, I didn't say that. Oh, no, I said a man who doesn't think anyone else wants him. A great difference.
Huh? Yeah. Norma Shearer was originally slated to be in this film, but her husband had a heart attack. She had to nurse him back to health. What you see in this movie, not necessarily in this clip, is you see women dealing honestly with their own lust and also their own disgust with men. These are two things that, forget about it, after June 1934, when censorship came in, it went away. What's nice about this festival is they, at the end of the festival, they're having three double features in a row. They're all Norma Shearer films. Shearer has gotten this rap on the basis of like one or two movies that she made late in her career that she was kind of a milquetoast. Actually, she made the most risque, sexy films of the 30s. It just so happens that they were in the early 30s, and these films are rarely revived. But a film like The Divorcee set a trend towards sophistication in film that was really kind of astounding, and it's only the Catholic Legion of Decency and people coming in that could stop it.
Let's go to the second film clip. It is The Divorcee, starring the famous Norma Shearer.
And I thought your heart was breaking like mine. But instead you tell me your man's pride can't stand the gas.
Now, wait a minute, Jerry, listen.
Oh, I don't want to listen. I'm glad I've discovered there's more than one man in the world while I'm young and they want me. Believe me, I'm not missing anything from now on.
I don't doubt it. Once a woman throws down her fences...
Oh, pin it on a motto and hang it where Janice can see it.
Stop that.
Oh, loose women, great, but not in the home, eh, Ted?
Cut it, do you hear?
The looser they are, the more they get. The best in the world, no responsibility. Well, my dear, I'm going to find out how they do it. So look for me in the future where the primroses grow. And pack your man's pride with the rest.
She told him.
Well, you know, what's happening is that he got drunk and had a one-night stand with another woman, so she
more in a spirit of inquiry rather than revenge, went out that night and went to bed with his best friend. And now they're having it out. I mean, just forget about this ever happening after 1934. If that seems old-fashioned, and it does because it's an antique, it's 65 years ago, keep in mind that it was another 40 years after that. You have to go to like Ellen Burstyn, Jill Clayburgh, Jane Fonda before you even, these films are even attempted again. And that's really what's so wonderful about this period of film.
I'll tell you one thing, Mick, I got to say, my dad, his name is Lyle Talbot, 93 years old, was in a lot of these movies that are in the series with Betty Davis and Barbara Stanwyck and the others, a couple. And I'll tell you, he loved those women. That was a great period for him to be working in.
Yeah.
And they had a lot of fun when they were making films, too.
Is this a case where there were just better characters in the films, or were the women actors better?
Better writers?
Well, it's a little bit of all those things, but I think better characters to an extent. I mean, if you look at Shearer, let's say, look at the Shearer films. She's always friends with women. She's always a complete person. She's not, you know, if you look at the cast list of most films, most modern films, there's one woman, four guys. You know, she's the girlfriend. You know, Shearer always has friends. She's always, and the same thing with, you know, Anne Harding and all these women, Betty Davis. And so they were more integrated into the world. It was a great period.
And so the festival starts, the Roxy?
Starts tonight, goes through Monday, March 13th, and you check it out.
That's a good word. Thank you very much, Mick.
What is there to see? Well, there's something playing for just one day, today, at San Francisco's Roxie Cinema that I personally would not miss. It's called The Divorcee, and it's a film that's part of the Roxy's Women of the 30s Festival. It was made 65 years ago, in 1930. It came 4 years before censorship came to Hollywood and forced intelligent, wonderful actresses to all act like bubbleheads.
You've been trying to forget quite a lot, haven't you, Jerry?
Who told you that?
Starring the great Norma Shearer in her Academy Award-winning role, this is a film that even people who don't like old movies can't resist. A surprisingly modern picture about a woman finding her way to her own morality following a nasty divorce.
Well, you don't exactly take the veil when your decree is granted, you know.
So I understand.
Oh, that sounds disapproving. What should an ex-wife do? Spend her days doing good deeds? Going to bed at night with suitable books.
Tomorrow, the Norma Shearer mini-festival continues at the Roxy with Strange Interlude, one of the weirdest films of all time.
Wonder what's happened to their marriage. Felt a bit sorry for myself at their wedding. She always had a strong attraction for me. One reason I've steered clear. Need all my mind on my work.
Well, what do you think's wrong with your patient now, Doctor? I suppose you can't help that diagnostic stare.
These films are antiques, and it may take the uninitiated about 10 minutes to get onto their rhythm. But in the case of The Divorcee and some of these other films, it really will definitely be worth it. For Channel 7 News, I'm Mick LaSalle.
New.
Okay, look, I know it's Sunday night, you're all cozy, who wants to go out? But right now, you have less than an hour to get over to San Francisco's Roxy Cinema by 7:30 to see a rare screening of a film that's at least one of my all-time favorites. The 1930 drama called The Divorcee.
You've been trying to forget quite a lot, haven't you, Jerry?
Who told you that?
Starring the great Norma Shearer in her Academy Award-winning role, this is a film that even people who don't like old movies can't resist. A surprisingly modern picture about a woman finding her way to her own morality following a nasty divorce.
Well, you don't exactly take the veil when your decree is granted, you know.
So I understand.
Oh, that sounds disapproving. What should an ex-wife do? Spend her days doing good deeds, going to bed at night with suitable books.
Tomorrow, the Norma Shearer mini-festival continues at the Roxy with Strange Interlude, one of the weirdest films of all time.
Wonder what's happened to their marriage. Felt a bit sorry for myself at their wedding. She always had a strong attraction for me. One reason I've steered clear. Need all my mind on my work.
Well, what do you think's wrong with your patient now, Doctor? I suppose you can't help that diagnostic stare.
I think The Divorcee is definitely worth going out on a cold night to see, but be warned, these films are antiques, so it may take the uninitiated about 10 minutes to get onto their rhythm.